We've experienced some quite rough weather yesterday in particular, and she handles it great, so should be the perfect ship to take around the world.
One of Extreme's biggest challenges is moving the fleet of Odyssey 21s around the globe in the most carbon efficient way possible. A unique problem that required a unique solution in the form of the St. Helena. Originally built in 1989 to service the inhabitants' needs on the remote island of the same name, the St. Helena has undergone a huge transformation for its new life.
So over the last 2 years, there's been an amazing amount of work gone on from the project team purchasing the St. Helena, bringing her back and refitting her. An amazing amount of work and effort from everyone.
She's had a complete refurbishment from top to bottom. That refurbishment includes 40 tons of steelwork. All the engines have been refurbished completely. All the fuel injection equipment has been replaced. All the component parts in the engine have been replaced. She now burns low sulfur fuel. The engines are as efficient as they ever could be. The fuel is basically the champagne of fuels. You can't get better fuel for a ship. The vessel won't be going at full speed, she'll be going at eco speed, which means that we get as much speed out of her for the lowest carbon footprint as possible. Basically, St. Helena is as new as the day that she came out of the shipyard 30 years ago.
St. Helena has got the passenger facilities, passenger cabins to be able to house the many crew that will be working on board, not only with the Extreme E program, but also with running the ship. And also she's got the two holds forward, she's got the crane capabilities to be able to lift up containers up and into the holds. So she's the best of both worlds.
With the engineering works finished, it was time for the ship to complete sea trials in order to check that all systems were ready to go.
Currently, we're doing our sea trials out in the Irish Sea, not too far away from Liverpool. And the idea of sea trials is to test the machinery, certainly with the main engines, and checking that everything's a ship shape, ready to go to sea to start our world series, our world cruise, as we call it. Certainly during the sea trials, we've experienced some quite rough weather yesterday in particular, and she handles it great, so should be the perfect ship to take around the world. Finishing touches when we get back into Liverpool, the preparations will continue for number one hold and number two hold. But of course we've got the laboratory which has been brought in, so that's going to be a really exciting area that I personally would be very interested in, to see what they're doing in there, analysing the environment, analysing various water samples, seeing where we're at. We want to leave the land better than how we found it, and hopefully the laboratory and their answers will be a key part to that. This ship is paving the way to a new future for the environment.